and whole grains and foods that are low in fat, that is fat, especially saturated fat, sugar and salt. The nutritious foods that constitute a healthy diet are not available or affordable for many people. That is why we are celebrating this World Food Day on October 16th of every year all over the world. World Food Day theme 2019. Each year has a different theme. The theme of World Food Day 2019 is Our Actions Are Our Future. I repeat, Our Actions Are Our Future. Healthy diet for a zero hunger world. Again, I repeat, healthy diet for a zero hunger world. Focus of the theme. It focuses on tackling global hunger. Due to globalization, urbanization, and income growth, our diets and eating habits are changed. Instead of seasonal fiber-rich food and plant-based food, we are shifted to refined starches, sugars, fats, salt, and processed food, that is junk food, etc. It has been seen that in urban areas, time spent on preparing food or meals is very less because the people these days rely on ready-made food, supermarkets, fast food, and street food. Due to unhealthy diets and sedentary lifestyles, obesity in people is increasing in developed and low-income countries. According to FAO, Food Agriculture Organization, 670 million adults and 120 million girls and boys of time aged from 5 to 18 years are obese, and 40 million children under 5 are overweight. Around 820 million people are suffering from hunger. Hence, we are celebrating this World Food Day. A World Food Day official symbol consists of three abstract human figures: harvesting, distributing and sharing food. The figures are depicted in a bluish grey color.
Right, now below the circle, tear out in the middle of rectangle. Here are the rectangle. Below the circle.
And I was by then, I was very angry, I was irritated.
Okay, I would have said something to that man, but I didn't. Last minute, what he did, the last biscuit, he took that biscuit and I also reached for it, but he, you know, was faster. He took the biscuit, he broke it in half, left half for me, and he got up from the seat, looked at me, smiled and walked away. By now, I was really angry. Okay, I didn't know whether to be angry with my daughter or with my husband back there or if this man would come and just eaten all my biscuits. By the time I could think of it, the announcement for my flight had come. So I went, they had to check in, no? So I went to take out the tickets and all that. And then I looked into my handbag, the biscuit packet which I had bought was in my handbag. I had been eating from that man's biscuit packet without even knowing, right? So what do you learn from this in life? You learn that you have to, it's very easy for us to blame, yeah? College doesn't do this for us, my parents don't do this, they're not buying me this, whatever. So many things, my mother doesn't cook properly. So many different complaints you can give. But we have to look at it from the other person's point of view. That day that man taught me a lesson, right? He looked at it from my point of view. He saw me as an individual who was hungry with a little baby, who was tired, right? And he had the niceness to share the biscuit packet without even letting me know it was his packet. Right? And I still thank that person, even today. Got it? Now, second. So empathy is the first quality. One is we all should know we are unique. Okay? You all are capable of doing anything, achieving anything in life. Each one of you. Some may be good in academics, some may be good in sports, some may be good at something, but you will be good at something. Find out what it is. Point number one. Point two is empathize. Look at things from the other person's point of view. Right? Somebody is not your, the person who is sweeping the floor every day in college. If you pick up the paper today, it will make things easier for her today, tomorrow. Right? So empathize, think of the person, think of everything from the other person's point of view. Point number three is, I'm going to do a small exercise. Okay, listen to me carefully and just follow whatever I do. Right, touch your head. Touch your eyes, cheek, head, eyes, nose, eyes, cheek, chin. What are you doing? What are you doing? You did not listen. We as human beings don't listen. God has given us 2 ears and 1 mouth. And what did we do? We like talk. Have you seen it? No. One of the reasons why we're so successful is a very good listener. Right? Take Pranav, like who's another, supposed to be another good leader. Right? Did we talk more? No. Abdul Kalam, his birthday just went by. Did we talk more? No, you listen more. You listen and then talk where necessary, when necessary. Right? So that point. Another exercise which you'll have to do. Cross your hands. Now, see if it's difficult. Put your hands out like this. Watch which, find out which thumb is over the other. Or take it out, put the other way down. Difficult? No. It will be a little uncomfortable. Not difficult, it will be uncomfortable. Why? Because it's become habit. Did anybody teach you how to cross your hands? Did your parents tell you this is how you should cross your hands? No. How did it come? How did it happen? By habit. It takes 21 days to change your habit. So if you're used to getting up at 11 o'clock in the holidays, right? If you're used to just being lazy, if you're just used to watching a lot of using your mobile phone a lot, if you are used to watching all the trash in the name of television serials, all those habits can be broken. It's not useful at all. Once in a while, okay, but not always. Right? So that. And the fifth point is never gratitude. If you look at anybody great, anybody successful, they don't forget the people they have who have helped them be where they are. Whether it is your parents, whether it is your teachers, Abdul Kalam had a favorite teacher, right? Who was a person whom he took to the presidential palace, right? The Rashtrapati Bhavan. You have everyone else. You remember teachers who really helped you through. Be grateful.
be grateful to your management, be grateful to your, especially to your parents. Most of us today, you find old age homes, you find people being just thrown there. Right? Be thankful to them. Be thankful to the person who's cleaning your classrooms, who's making food for you every day, your drivers, everybody. They deserve that respect and that, you know, the dignity of labor for what they're doing. That respect has to be given at all times and at every time. Not only here, everywhere. Right? Even the person who is, the person who collects your garbage at home, outside your houses, how many of you say that it's a kukka karyam and all that? No, don't ever do that. They are individuals. They have a name. Right? Address them by their name, add an anna or something. You've made their name. Right? So learn to respect people and learn to love India. Because if each of us love our country, we will definitely, you know, do something for our country. With these words, I thank you again for listening to me so quietly and patiently. God bless you all. Thank you so much.
பெண்களும் இந்த பயிற்சியில் ஒரு இன்டர்நேஷனல் லெவலில் நேஷனல் சாம்பியன்ஷிப் வந்து அந்த போட்டியில் கலந்துக்கணும் அப்படின்னு வருகிற அடுத்த மாதம் வந்து ஒரு 4 days வந்து இங்கே ஒரு கராத்தே காம்படிஷன் ஒன்று நடத்துறதுக்காக தான் அவங்க இன்னைக்கு நம்ம ஊருக்கு வந்திருக்காங்க. அவங்களுக்கு எங்களுடைய ரோட்டரி கிட்டம் சார்பாகவும் விஜய் வித்யாலயா குருப்பம் இன்ஸ்டிடியூஷன் சார்பாகவும் மனமார்ந்த நன்றியை தெரிவித்துக் கொண்டு